Hello, I'm Romario Foucault. I came from Cameroon and currently a PhD candidate in mathematics at Morgan State University. I work under the supervision of Professor Gaston Gerekata and Professor Giselle Mofo. My career goal is to become a real-life problem solver. In fact, the more complex the society is, the more mathematical needs are felt. Well, after my PhD studies, I intend to remain in academic framework as a researcher trying to contribute for resolution of problems related to industries. For the 92nd Annual National Technical Association Virtual Conference, we are going to talk about hierarchy control of a linear heat equation with missing data. We will follow this outline. This image shows that industries are altering lakes and streams. But equation one may ask is the following: are we able to clean up lakes when they are already polluted? If yes, how can we proceed? For example, we all know that fishes need oxygen to survive. But when pesticides and heavy metals find themselves inside lakes and streams, fishes can be harmed or even killed. Our objective is then to control the diffusion of a pollutant in a lake using the stacked bed strategy, particularly when we don't have any information about when the pollution started. The stacked bed strategy involves two controls. The follower brings the state to a desired state, while the leader has to bring the system to rest at a final time. How does the stacked Elbert strategy work? The user transmits the concentration of pollutant. The follower adjusts it until it reaches the desired state. Then the leader clears the pollutant at the final time. In 1992, Lyons introduced the notions of low regret control and no regret control in order to solve problems with missing data. Since then, many authors have used these notions to control models with incomplete data. For instance, Giselle Mofo proved in 2017 that the low regret control associated with a boundary functional diffusion equation has a unique solution, which converges to the no regret control. In 1994, Jacques-Louis Lyons used the stacked bed strategy on a system governed by a parabolic equation subject to two controls, the follower and the leader. In 2007, Nakulima used the stacked bed strategy for a backward heat equation involving the leader and the follower by means of Kalman inequality. Here is our model. Y represents the state of the system. H and V are our controls, V being the follower, H the leader, G the initial data, the initial condition which is missing. With this cost function, we wish to act on the state of our system in order to obtain what we desire and possibly at low cost. But we have one challenge. This missing information makes the problem difficult to solve. But we use Lyon's idea to get rid of it and proceed. The optimization problem three is the low regret control problem. Lyon proved that the low regret control solution to this problem converges to the no regret control. For this non-controllability problem, we drive the dynamic of equilibrium by means of a suitable choice of control. We consider these two species. The low regret control is characterized by this optimality system given by 7, 8, 9, 10, and 11. As sketch of proof for this theorem, we first of all need to transform our optimization problem into an equivalent optimal control problem given by 12. For proof of this lemma, we use Fenchel-Lejeune transform. Now, going back to the proof of our theorem, we use the lower semi-continuity and strict convexity of the cost function J gamma to prove that D The optimization problem 3 has a unique solution. Then, by means of Euler-Lagrange optimality condition, we prove that the optimal control V gamma is characterized by the optimality system given in the theorem. The no-regret control is quantified by 15, and the leader is characterized by this optimality system given by 16, 17, 18, 19, and 20. For this second result, we first of all establish an appropriate Kalman inequality satisfied by the adjoint state of the system which characterizes the optimal control V gamma. Then, to solve this null controllability problem, we penalize the solution from the final time t to the target 0. For the rest of the proof for this second theorem, we proceed in steps. First of all, using minimizing sequence, we prove that there exists a unique optimal control H epsilon gamma solution to 21. Now, writing the Euler-Lagrange first order optimality condition, we find the system that characterizes the optimal control H epsilon gamma. Next, we use the so-called Kalman inequality to find some a priori estimates on the variables. Then, we use those estimates to move to the limit when epsilon goes to zero in the system that characterizes our optimal control H epsilon gamma. And then, this allows us to deduce the result of our theorem. Finally, we were able to prove, following Lyon's idea, that despite the fact that the initial condition in our system is unknown, this problem is Taquet-Bell null controllable. But the only condition is that the follower control state should be included strictly in the leader control state. This means that we cannot expect, in general, the control H hat gamma to commit to a Taquet-Bell strategy leader action if the above condition is not satisfied. We are really grateful of the School of Computer, Mathematical and Natural Sciences for financial support throughout this project. This work has already been published, and we are sincerely thankful for the three anonymous referees for their helpful suggestions. Finally, we thank the NTA Selection Committee for this opportunity which was given to us to present this work. Thank you once again for your kind attention. Please stay safe during this pandemic period.